Hi, my name is Andrey, and today we'll talk about structuring shopping campaigns in 2023. If you want to run Google Shopping Ads, you create either standard shopping or performance max campaign. Pmax, a new campaign type, had the highest adoption rate last year. Many people went full speed with it, with sometimes poor results. Today I'll show you how to avoid those early mistakes. We'll cover these topics: why split shopping campaigns, the bare minimum account setup, what to expect from Pmax, shopping-only Pmax. We'll look at four typical account structures, compare them in terms of ease of setup, ease of maintenance, and performance, and finally answer some most common questions. Let's go. Let's look at the reasons to split shopping campaigns. There are usually two types of reasons. First is obvious or logistical reasons. For example, if you sell in different countries, you have to run separate campaigns. Also for convenience, if you sell winter wear and summer swimwear, for example, it's only convenient to have them in two separate campaigns and turn on, turn off per campaign, than to do that by the product or product category in one campaign. Also, if you have specific budget requirements per product categories, you control it by putting them in a separate campaigns. And of course, when you experiment, which you always should be doing to improve performance, you also do that in separate campaigns in many, many cases. The idea behind the performance split is you separate subset of products and apply different settings, different budget, different bidding, and try to optimize performance this way. Examples could be bestsellers versus regular products, promotions versus non-promotions, discounted products, low stock, overstocked, and so on. Let's look at the bare minimum account setup, or as I call it, don't run your account without it. Accurate conversion tracking. Make sure you have native Google Ads conversion tracking. Don't import analytics conversions. In the Merchant Center, fix all the account and feed related issues. Fix all item disapprovals. Optimize product titles in the feed. I've made a video about it. Check the link in the description. Run dynamic remarketing and search campaigns. Search campaigns sometimes bring more revenue with better ROAS in e-commerce accounts. Dedicate at least 20 to 50 or 60% of total budgets to search and up to 10% to remarketing campaigns. What should you expect from Pmax? Pmax is a new campaign type that combines many ad types: shopping, search, YouTube, display, discovery, and so on. Pmax is still easier to set up and maintain than the standard shopping campaign. Because Pmax runs different ad types, it spends not only on shopping, but on search and video and display ads. So there is always going to be the non-shopping costs in the Pmax campaigns. Expect several weeks of lower performance initially or after big changes in the campaign. This is called the learning period, when the campaign collects and analyzes conversion data. To minimize learning period, make your changes smaller and make them less frequently. For example, to change a budget, make changes once a week and not more than 20%. The same goes for bidding. Also, Pmax has limited reporting, which may not be an issue for you, but for bigger accounts, it becomes really important to control everything, and Pmax is not the best in this case. Let's talk about shopping-only Performance Max campaigns. Essentially, it's a way to configure Performance Max to try to run only shopping ads. It can be set up in Google Ads or in Google Ads Editor. Both versions are described in my videos with the links in the description. And the campaign essentially becomes like a smart shopping campaign. Unfortunately, there are two problems with this approach. One is that shopping-only traffic is not guaranteed. It happens because the campaign will eventually start automatically adding the assets, text and video assets, and the non-shopping traffic can reach up to 50% in the total cost. The second one is that Google, while acknowledges this type of running Pmax campaign, does not recommend it. And it's possible that in the future, this way of running or at least creating a Pmax campaign will not be available anymore. So use it while it lasts, do some testing, and if it doesn't work the way you want it, replace it with standard shopping. Let's look at some examples of campaign structures. When you have a new account or under 30 conversions a month, I recommend to run standard shopping campaign with manual cost per click. The goal is to get some traffic and conversions before upgrading to another campaign structures. Use all budget you allocate for shopping ads for this campaign. The standard single campaign is harder to set up and manage than the Pmax campaign, and you get average performance at best. But you might not have any other choice. With such low conversion value, I don't recommend using other campaign types because it's very easy to waste your money with not enough data. Pmax Turbo. When you have at least 30 conversions per month, then it makes sense to try Performance Max. It's very similar setup. Put all your products in a single Pmax campaign and run max conversions value bid strategy. It will allow you to stay within your budget when counted monthly. The Pmax Turbo is the easiest to set up and manage among all the structure examples, and it can deliver better than average performance. Pmax Split. When you get a lot more conversions per campaign, at least 30, you can separate campaigns in order to maximize efficiency. So in this case, we have a two campaign structure with the bestsellers and regulars. Bestsellers have a max conversion value bid strategy and 60% of budget. And the idea is that bestsellers, we put the most budget because they deliver and we don't restrict them by any target. Regulars, we don't want to spend too much. It's 40% and we don't want to spend too high cost per click, and we control it by target ROAS. We can basically increase target ROAS, which is equivalent of reducing cost per click. Very important to determine bestsellers, don't look in Google Ads, look in analytics in the e-commerce section for product IDs. For more details, check the link in the description. I made a video about it. This strategy is relatively easy to set up and manage. It's still Performance Max. The complication comes from maybe the deciding between several campaigns, allocating budgets, and deciding on bidding strategies. And it's more effective than typically than single Pmax campaign. Standard split. With higher budgets, say from 20K per month, control becomes a lot more important. You want to control searches, you want to control negatives, and so on. And this is only possible with a standard campaign. So standard campaign is still the most flexible and most manageable campaign for large budgets and can get very good results. This is a specific example of an account in an industry that thrives on promotions. Account has a very high number of monthly conversions, at least maybe 200 or 300 or even a lot higher. And you always have products on promotions and you know that they perform with higher ROAS reliably. So you put promotional products in its own campaign with higher target ROAS and you allocate 40% of budget to it. Then you put the remaining products into a standard other campaign with a slightly lower TROs and 50% budget. Finally, you run a catch-all campaign for all products with a manual bid strategy and very low bids. In addition, you use campaign priorities and negative keywords to sculpt in common traffic for better performance. These type of controls are only available in a standard shopping campaign type. This example of the account structure is hard to set up and requires active management, but it has the potential to deliver the best performance. Let's compare the four account structures. The structures with the Pmax campaigns number 2 and 3 are easier to set up and manage. Standard campaigns structures number 1 and 4 are harder to set up and manage, but on the flip side, they provide better control and fine-tuning opportunities. You get the best performance with standard split, but it only works for large budgets and a large amount of conversion. Let's say for the most of stores, Pmax or Pmax Turbo or Pmax Split will be the best options. But of course, you need to keep experimenting and try different campaign structures. Let's answer some questions I received about the campaign structures and the Pmax campaigns. Can I mix feed-only and complete asset groups in a Pmax campaign? Technically you can, but I don't see any advantage of doing this. For the bestseller setup, do you pick the best products or categories? That depends on your bestsellers. If your bestsellers' products happen to be in one category, it will only simplify your setup. Can I mix Pmax and standard shopping campaigns? Yes, as long as you understand that Pmax has priority over standard shopping campaigns. For example, in my last structure example, standard split, you could run the standard promotions campaign as Pmax. Can I target the same products in several campaigns? Generally, it's not a good idea because the Pmax or standard campaign with a higher priority will get all the traffic. There are two exceptions. One is a catch-only standard campaign that helps to catch products missed by Pmax. It happens because Pmax will sometimes stop serving certain products. The second exception is a search query sculpting structure where all campaigns should target the same products. Is there a good way to test account consolidation? Yes, use portfolio bid strategies and shared budgets to combine campaigns with similar performance targets. It simplifies management. For example, you can change targets more easily or remove poor performing campaigns from the portfolio. If you don't find an answer to your specific question, write me in the comments. Thank you and have a great day.